स्थापकायधर्मस्वधर्मस्वरूपिणी अवतार वरिष्ठाय रामकृष्णाय ते नमः। जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयो श्रित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। नमः श्रीयतिराजाय विवेकानन्दसूरये सचिसुखस्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे। My namaskars to all of you. Today is an auspicious day. Today, Swami Sharadananda's Jayanti, Janmatithi. So on this occasion, we'll be discussing something related to his life. We see a florist. He picks different kinds of flowers and he makes one bouquet. It looks nice. So in the same way, Sri Ramakrishna also, he selected different kinds of people from the companions of previous divine incarnations, and he brought them to fulfill his mission. One day in Dakshineshwar, Sri Ramakrishna sat on the lap of one young person, young boy. Then he was telling, just I was testing how much weight he could bear. So later, that young man is none other than our Swami Sharadananda Maharaj. His name was Sharad Chandra Chakravarti. He was born in Calcutta on 23rd December 1865. His father name was Girish Chandra Chakravarti. Mother was Nilmani Devi, and they belong to devout Brahmin family, and they are well-to-do. So Shatman was born on Saturday. Today also coincidence, it is Saturday. So from young age, Sharat was very gentle and very soft nature, and he was incapable of using any harsh words towards anyone. He was very kind. And from his mother, he developed religious attitude. He was watching mother's doing puja. So from that, he was so much inclined towards spiritual life. So he learned how to chant mantras and all. After his sacred third ceremony, Upanayana, he was doing puja and all at home. And he was very helpful in school days to his batchmates. Suppose any of his friends were very poor, he would help them. He would give his short tandal to them, and his pocket money he would use for purchasing books for them. As a young boy, he was very he was well built. He used to go to gymnasium and develop his body. So he has a strong body. In those days in Calcutta, Keshav Chandra Sen is a Brahmin Samaj leader. He was very popular. So on one occasion, one of his friends came across one article written by Keshav Chandra Sen in one Indian magazine. They were very much impressed by that article. So they are very interested to meet Sri Ramakrishna in Dakshineshwar. So one day, some of his friends, they all went to Sri Ramakrishna in Dakshineshwar. As usual, when someone comes, Sri Ramakrishna would invite them cordially, and he inquired, and he was telling the boys, when bricks and tiles, if they are burnt after making stamp on them, it would last forever. So in the same way, in young age, everyone should taste the spirituality, and outwards they can enter into the worldly life. So this divine wisdom very much attracted our Sharat. So he started going frequently. His college was holiday on Thursday. So Thursday he used to go. And Sri Ramakrishna became very close to him. Then as he started coming, then our Sri Ramakrishna, he was very much eager that he should become close to Narendra. One day he was telling, Narendra was a very fine boy. He is master in many things. He can sing, in vocal he is master, instrumental, and he can speak nicely, and he can meditate for long hours. So you should meet him. Then Sharat got interested. Then he went and met Narendra. Then they both became very close. Then afterwards, Sri Ramakrishna came to know that they both became very close. He was very happy. Then one day, Sri Ramakrishna asked, "What divine vision do you like to have?" Then Sharat told, "I don't want any vision. I want to see God in all beings." Then Sri Ramakrishna told, "It is not so easy. It is the last word in spiritual life. We have to struggle a lot." Then the boy replied, "I am ready for that. I want only that. I will not be satisfied anything short of that." So he wanted to see God in all human beings. Then one day, after some time, Sri Ramakrishna's health, he got this throat cancer, and from Dakshineshwar he got shifted to Shambhapur. From there he went to Kasipur. Kasipur, we all know, recently we celebrated Kalpataru Day. So on Kalpataru Day, many people got blessings from Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna blessed them, "Be illumined, Chaitanya ho, Chaitanya ho." So that time, our Sharat was there on the terrace cleaning Sri Ramakrishna's room, but he did not go to get his blessings. Then someone asked, "Why you did not go?" Then he said, "Sri Ramakrishna is my own, so I don't have to ask anything. Whatever I require, surely he will give. So that's why I did not feel to go," like that he said. After some time, Bodo Gopal, later he became Swami Advaitanandaji, he wanted to give 12 rosaries and 12 akar clothes to monks. Then Sri Ramakrishna said, "These young boys you can give." Then he gave to Sri Ramakrishna. Sri Ramakrishna gave that garba cloth and rosaries to these boys. Sharat also won among them to receive from Sri Ramakrishna. After Thakur's passing away, all these young disciples, they became more and more restless for the reason of God. They went to many pilgrimage places. They did a lot of sadhana. And these boys, they found one monastery in Baranagar. So Sharat used to visit now and then. But father did not like. Father wanted Sharat to study medicine and become a doctor. But Sharat was not interested. So one day what happened? Sharat's father, he put him in one room and locked. What we say, when a river is obstructed, it flows more ferociously. So his longing increased. So his brother unlocked the door and Sharat went to Baranagar Monastery. Then there all that Narendra, other friends were there. So Sharat was staying with them. He was learning music, how to sing, how to play tabla from Narendra. And Sharat's voice, just like female voice. So one day night in that Baranagar Monastery, Sharat was singing. From distance, it looks like some woman voice. So neighbors got doubt. What is this in monastery? Some woman voice coming at night time like that. Then they got out and they climbed the boundary wall and went and saw. It was Sharat. He was singing. Then they felt very embarrassed and they begged their forgiveness. Afterwards, all these young disciples, they went to Anandpur, and one night they spent whole night. They did, they lit one dhuni, and around that they sat and they did spiritual whole night japa meditation. And it was Christmas Eve. That it was Christmas Eve. Later on, they all took monastic vows in Baranagar monastery, performing Virja Homa. And Narendra gave Sharadananda to Sharad. So now he became Swami Sharadananda. Afterwards, he had gone to many pilgrimage places like Puri, Bodh Gaya, Varanasi, Ayodhya, Haridwar, Rishikesh, next Gangotri, Ambadrinath, Kedarnath. He did lot of tapasya. Again, he came back to Baranagar. When he was in Rishikesh, one incident happened. They went to one Nilakanteshwar Shiva to see God there. He and Swami Turiyanandaji. On the way, it was thick jungle. Now Rishikesh is not that much jungle, but those days it was thick jungle. So it's full of ferocious animals. So when they were returning, they lost the way. Then they decided, both of us, instead of going in the same direction, let us go in different directions. Then Turiyanandaji went in one direction, Sharadanandaji went in another direction. Turiyanandaji could reach one ashram and he took shelter there, but Sharadanandaji could not find the way. So what he did, he was there in the jungle at night time. Then next day, Turiyanandaji went in search of him with taking one more help. Then they saw him, he was sitting on the rock and doing meditation. Then they asked, why he sat like that? Then Maharaj replied, when death is certain, it is better to die chanting the name of God. Means he was fearless, though he was alone and in midst of that thick jungle full of ferocious animals, he was not afraid. Just he was chanting, taking the name of God. Then Swamiji, Swami Vivekananda went to foreign. Then he was preaching Vedanta there. After some time, he wanted one assistant. So he called Sharat Maharaj, you come and help me there. He was a little assistant, Sharat Maharaj. Then he went and asked Holy Mother. Then Mother said, okay, no problem, you can go. Wherever you go, Thakur will protect you. So he went there in 1896. Then there he was attending Swami Vivekananda's lectures and he learnt how to give talk. One day what happened? Sarath Mara was giving talk and Goodwin was listening, sitting on the chair. Then Goodwin suddenly started laughing. Then Sarath Mara became nervous. He thought, maybe I am not lecturing properly. That's why he's laughing. Then afterwards he asked, why did you laugh? Then Goodwin told, you are talking nicely. That's why I was happy like that. Then another fun incident happened. Sarath Maharaj, he was in Ridley Manor. There, Miss McLeod. So Maharaj was staying there and giving talks. So every day Miss McLeod, she would come. And she would inquire the Swami, Swami, did you sleep well? Then one day what happened? Sarath Maharaj was giving lecture and Miss McLeod sitting among the audience and she was sleeping. Then after the lecture, then the Swami asked, did you sleep well like that? So he was very successful in the West. Then meanwhile what happened? Swami Vivekananda, after coming back to India, he started Ramakrishna Mission. So he wanted one helping hand. So again he called him back. So Sarath Maharaj again, he came back to India in 1898. Then Ramakrishna Mission, Swami Vivekananda, he appointed Swami Brahmananda as a spiritual head, means Sangadhyaksha. Then Swami Sharadananda became general secretary, that is executive head. Then Swamiji having a lot of confidence in Sharath Maharaj, because by nature he is very balanced and soft and very kind-hearted. So Swamiji selected Sharath Maharaj as General Secretary of Ramakrishna Math and Ramakrishna Order. So in this position nearly 3 decades, from 1898 to 1927, he continued that General Secretaryship. That time it was under British rule. It was very tough time, but even then Sharath Maharaj managed very nicely. Then meanwhile Swami Vivekananda went once again to West, then again he came back. Then he wanted, before his lifetime, that our mission should be in a proper working condition. So sometimes he used to get angry. Once what happened, he gave some work to Sharath Maharaj and it was not done. Swamiji became very angry. Then he scolded him left and right. Then what happened, while Swamiji was scolding, someone came with the tea, serving tea. Then Sharath Maharaj took tea and silently was taking. Swamiji became very angry. See, Sharath's blood very cold, never get warm up. I'm scolding, still he is not angry. Afterwards, Swami Trikuna Tithananda, he had to go to foreign. Then he was editor of on Bengali magazine, Udbodhan. Then when he went, our Sharath Maharaj took over that. He became the editor of Udbodhan. Then started one main stage in Sharath Maharaj's life, that is taking care of Holy Mother. Holy Mother had 3 attendants. One, Yogin Maharaj. He passed away very early. Afterwards, Swami Trikuna Tithananda used to take care. Now, he was going to foreign. So, Sharath Maharaj became the attendant. So, for Holy Mother, when she come to Kolkata, there was no place. She has to stay in some guest house or in some rent house or in devotee's house. And mothers by nature very shy. So, and not only mother, along with mother, Raju, Raju's mother, some party, always they were together. So it was very inconvenient for mother to stay in somebody's house. Then Sharath Maharaj felt very bad. Mother should have some, her own place. So what he did, he borrowed some money and he started building one house for mother. That is now is called Udbodhan, we call Mayerbadi. So in that, 2 floors. Ground floor is the office for Udbodhan magazine. First floor is living quarters for mother. Mother is very close to Sharath Maharaj. Always she used to depend on him. When she was in Jayarambati, suppose if someone tells mother, come, let us go to Kolkata, then she would tell, just inquire whether Sharath is there or not, then only I will go. And suppose when mother is in Udbodhan, if Sharath Maharaj wants to go somewhere, he will come and tell mother, just I'm going here, like that. Then mother will tell, hey, wait my child, first let me go to Jayarambati, then outwards you can go. So when Sharath Maharaj was there, mother always used to feel very comfortable. And Sharath Maharaj, he did so much for mother and mother family. He arranged marriage for Radhu. And among mother's brothers, there was a lot of quarrel about this property, how to share among them. Then mother asked Sharath Maharaj's help. Then Sharath Maharaj went and he settled all that family issues. So mother became very settled because of that one. Then whenever mother feel, whenever mother's health little disturbed, then Sharath Maharaj immediately he would go. Suppose she was in Jayarambati, if he comes to know that mother is not well, immediately would send doctor. Sometimes he himself would go. So like that, always mother, mother, mother. Then when mother is in Udbodhan, Sharath Maharaj used to stay one room next to, just as we enter now, it is on the left side. So there he used to tell himself as doorkeeper of mother. though he was the general secretary of the Ramakrishna order, always he used to tell himself as, I am the doorkeeper of mother. So it is a very difficult task. Sometimes so many devotees will come, he has to regulate them, and some will not listen to him. Once what happened, mother just came late from devotee's house, and Sharat Maharaj below sitting. Then one young man came. Then he said, I want to see mother. Then Sharat Maharaj told, now just only mother came, she tired, you cannot see. Then that black man became very angry. Mother, only mother for you? Then he just pushed Sharat Maharaj and went above. Then he met mother. Then afterwards, he felt bad. I did not behave properly with the Swami. Then he told mother also. Mother said, don't worry, you will not be angry. Then while coming down, he thought, if Swami is not there, it will be nice. So he was coming stealthily. But the Swami was there. Then he went and made pranam, begged forgiveness. Then immediately Sharat Maharaj embraced him. He told, why are you asking sorry? Yes, like that longing should be there to see mother. So you have that longing, I am very happy with, like that Maharaj said. Means he is very kind-hearted, he never gets angry. Then once someone went to mother, mother, I want initiation. Then mother told, did you tell Sharat? Then that man said, I don't know Sharat, I know only you, you give initiation. Then mother said, no, nothing doing. First go to Sharat, whatever he says, it will be done. Then he went to Sharat Maharaj. Sharat Maharaj arranged initiation for him. So during last days, mother's health was very bad. So she used to behave like a small child. So Sarala Didi was her attendant. She used to feed mother. So mothers every day at night, 11 p.m., mother should be fed milk. Sometimes she will tell, I will not take. Then Sarala Didi, she will tell. Then shall I call Sharat Maharaj? Then mother will tell, no, I will take. Once what happened, one day mother was not willing to take milk. Then Sarala Didi told, shall I call Sharat Maharaj? Then mother said, okay, you call, no problem. Then she called Sharat Maharaj, Sharat Maharaj came. Then mother was complaining. See, this girl, she knows only two things. She tells always, eat, eat, eat. Then that thermometer is there, she would put under my arm. So these two things only she knows. I will not take. Then Sharat Maharaj told mother, okay, here afterwards, she will not trouble you much. But anyway, you take milk now. Okay, then she called Sarala Didi to give. Then mother told, no, no, I will not take from her. I will take from you. Then Sharat Maharaj sat near mother. Then he was holding that feeding cup, little pour, and mother was just drinking. So while mother was drinking like that, then Sharat Maharaj told, Ma, little wait and take. In Bengali, we say, ek to jiriya khan. Then mother was very much touched. See, my son, how much concern. Others don't know how to speak. See, how nicely speaking. He is telling, Ma, little wait and take. Ek to jiriya khan. So it was very touching incident. So actually, Sarat Maharaj, he had one desire that I should serve mother personally. Something I want to feed. So this mother understood. And before her departure, mother fulfilled his desire. Then one more incident happened when mother was not well. Doctor prescribed some bland diet. Mother was not happy. Means always taking that tasteless food. Naturally, you don't feel fed up with that. One day she told someone, you bring muri with fried gram. In Bengali, we call muri. Then they brought. Then afterwards, Sarat Maharaj came to know. But it is very harmful for her health. Then Sarat Maharaj went to take back that bowl. As soon as mother saw Sarat Maharaj, immediately she was hiding that bowl backside. Then she asked, son, what do you want? Then Sharat Maharaj told, I want that cup. Then she gave. Then Sharat Maharaj told, mother, now your health is not good. So if you take this one, it will worsen. So some other time when you feel better, I will arrange for you. Then he has taken away that. But afterwards, mother passed away. Shatma was also feeling very bad. Mother was about to eat. I have taken away from her. Then afterwards, one day, Rajamar came, Brahmanandji. Then Shatmaj told, like that one, it happened with mother. I'm feeling very bad. So now I will give the same thing for you. By feeding you, I feel that Holy Mother herself taking. Then he gave that muri, fried gram, and he fed Raja Maharaj. Then Shatmaraj went to leave. So like that, he was very much, Shatmar very much attached to mother. Every day morning, when goes for pranam, then he'll go and make pranam to mother. Then he would ask, Ma, Bala Chinto, Ma, how are you like that? Then mother will tell, Ami Bala Chi, Tum Kemon Acho Baba. Yes, so every day same inquiry. Every day Satmar would go, every day he will inquire, mother also will reply. So it is very loving relationship. For constructing Udbodhan, Shatmaj took loan to repay that. He started writing Sri Ramakrishna's biography, that is Sri Ramakrishna Lila Prasanga. Mainly three reasons for that. First one, as an editor of Udbodhan, he used to receive a lot of articles about Sri Ramakrishna, which were not true. He could not bear someone telling something untruth about Sri Ramakrishna. So he wanted to write one authentic biography. Then second one, he has to pay the money. So he was thinking that by selling these books, he will repay that amount. And another one, third one, what is actually ideal of Ramakrishna Mutt and Ramakrishna Mission? He want everyone should know. And Girish Chandra Ghosh was a devotee of Sri Ramakrishna. And he has given power of attorney to Sri Ramakrishna, Vakalthunama, we call in Bengali. So he has given, means everything he surrendered to Sri Ramakrishna. Many devotees started imitating him. Even he would tell, I have given power of attorney to Sri Ramakrishna. So no worry for me like that. So what is actually power of attorney to make others understand? So he started writing that one. So it took nearly 10 years. So while writing, he would read in front of mother, and then mother also will approve. So like that, he has written Sri Ramakrishna Lila Prasanga, which is authentic life history of Sri Ramakrishna. And Sri Ramakrishna's life, it was written till Kashipur incident, Kashipur event. There, he could not finish. What happened? Mother passed away in 1920. Then afterwards, Brahmanji also passed away in 1922. Then someone asked, Maharaj, please finish this book. Then Sarat Maharaj told, when Holy Mother was there, I used to feel a lot of inspiration after her departure. Then seeing Raja Maharaj, I used to feel inspiration. Now both of them have gone. So now I'm not feeling that inspiration to write. So in that Leela Prasanga, Sri Ramakrishna's life was recorded up to Kashipur event. And as a general secretary, he was very efficient. Though he was general secretary, there was no pride in him. Once what happened, one Swami from Vrindavan, he had written one letter to Sharat Maharaj that I am coming to Kolkata. This letter was somehow misplaced. Then that Swami came. Then Sharat Maharaj became angry. Why did you come without informing me? Then that Swami told, No Maharaj, I am already sent a letter. But the Swami became a little angry. Then after some time that letter was found. Then that Sharat Maharaj, he felt guilty. Oh, he was right. I was wrong. But I scolded him. Then he went to that Swami and asked for sorry, begged his forgiveness. Though he was the general secretary of the order, he was very humble. And Sharat Maharaj, he was Ajatasatru. No enemies for him. He was very loving. And Sadhu, some sadhus who could not exist in other centers and mentally disturbed, dejected and rejected by others, all used to take shelter with Sharat Maharaj. He was very loving. So he used to give a lot of freedom to them, and he put trust in them, and he gave a lot of love and encouragement. So that many who could not exist in other centers, they used to stay with Sharat Maharaj in Udbodhan. One funny incident happened. Swami Brahmanandi was not feeling well. So Sharat Maharaj and one doctor, Kanjilal, they were going by boat from Kolkata to Belur. So on the way, one big storm came and boat was about to get drowned. But Sharat Maharaj, he was not disturbed. Just he was smoking hubble bubble like that. Then this doctor became very angry. Hey, what kind of man you are? The boat was about to sink and you are quietly smoking hubble bubble like that. Then Sharat Maharaj told, is it wise to jump into the Ganga before it is drowned? Boat is drowned. Means he was very Sita Prajna. He is not disturbed by anything. Heat, cold, praise or blame. So it was very nice. Then after Brahmanji passing away, there was election for president who will become the Sangha Guru. There are two, one Shivanandaji Maharaj and Sharadanandaji. Many voted for Sharadanandaji. But Sharadanandaji told, Swamiji put me as General Secretary, so I will continue till my end in this position only. So he refused that president. After some time, somebody came, one monk is going to build mud. Then Sharat Maharaj told, you just tell Premanandji that I will come and visit. And it happened the same afternoon, again thunderstorm came. But Sharat Maharaj gave one word that I will come. So night he took one boat and went to meet Premanandji. Then Premanandji, their dinner over and he was resting. They were asking, hey, what is urgent to come in this bad weather? Then Sharat Maharaj told, I gave word that I would come. So I came. Means that truthfulness. Same Guru Maharaj also like that. Yata Guru Tada Shishya. Sharat Maharaj also very truthful. So like that, there are so many incidents to tell about Sharat Maharaj. Now, when we are coming to the end, in his old age, he developed so many health problems like diabetes and all. Then he was also feeling to retire from active life. Then he heard that mother told once in Jayarambati, many people will come. So they, many people, sadhus, then devotees will come. They should have some place to stay and think of God and stay happily. So Sharat Maharaj decided to build one temple in Jayarambati. So he built one temple in Jayarambati where mother was born, and another temple in Belur Mutt where that mother's body was cremated. So three temples, Udbodhan and Belur Mutt mother's temple and Jayarambati mother's temple, all the three were built by Sharat Maharaj. So after this building Jayarambati temple, then Sharat Maharaj thought, now my mission is completed. Then in 1927, so his health was down. One day, what happened? He went to the shrine and he was praying to mother. Mother just praying. Then he went to the temple, shrine, he was praying, then again coming back. Then again he went to shrine, again coming back. So like that many times happened. Then he came down and he was resting and he got a stroke. He became unconscious. So in that position he stayed for 13 days. Afterwards, on Krishnashtami day, Friday, 19th August 1927, attained holy mother. He attained Mahasamadhi. So throughout his life, he is like Stita Pritnya. And he was so much devoted to holy mother. Mother used to tell, he is like my Vasuki. Wherever I go, he spreads his hood and protect me. And he is my jail of my heart, like that. So on this holy day, by the grace of God, we are able to discuss about the life of Swami Saradanandaji Maharaj. I pray that we all get inspired by his divine life and progress towards spiritual path. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat. Sri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.